should be right back after this little bit of a mess. Are we? Yep, we're back. Let's wait a little bit for the chat to pick up. Or not chat, for the stream to pick up a little bit, for having been a little while before we start to talk. And now. Okay. This momentary crash was really annoying. And for some reason, we had a rise in the viewership just as we crashed. I have no idea why, but I had like 6 or 7 viewers that then disappeared when I went back online. I'm at 0 now. Well, that's great. Anyway, what we are doing here now is playing Crusader Kings, and we're keeping on with the playthrough. Where was I anyway? We've actually lost a few months of gameplay. So is France good? Maybe the AI does a new seed and they won't, but we played a few months in and France declared war on us. And that might maybe not happen. We'll see. It's weird, but this sort of random thing does on occasion happen. Yeah, we're just getting the defensive pack notifications. Just getting the steam thing. So I'm guessing they probably are. We'll see. Does France attack us? Will they? We'll just have to figure that one out. We're going to introduce the heir to the realm. He will exchange many pleasantries, so we're going to like, yeah, okay. Hopefully our new heir won't disappoint us. Dutch arrived in the Duchy of Westland from... Okay, a little bit of power changing hands within the realm. Nothing that we can't deal with. Let's actually just take a sec to look at the direct vassal realm. The good thing is Sweden, Russ, and Scotland are on a similar power level, so I'm actually not too afraid of having too many vassals that are doing too much. I'm not really afraid of having too powerful vassals at the moment. As Trond introduces himself to Mayor Ulf of Inverness, he is not only presents himself with grace, but also manages to impress Ulfhe by skillfully complimenting him. I taught him everything he knows. Yeah, that's pretty good. Okay. Yeah. We're probably just waiting for the threat to go down significantly. Let's see, Council members. Or maybe we're just gonna have a time of peace anyway to just have some stability things happening. Oh, he's really going well with this random girl. Meh, that's fine. Can't turn that one into a castle yet because of religions. It would be nice if you could convert this. It would be nice. Left the defensive pact. And all that. There's a lot of petty claims that I can give. Oh no. Oh, I don't want him to be depressed. Cheer up. Drained existing defensive pact. Just some defensive pact nonsense happening. Eh, that's fine. You're gonna need a little bit more force. Okay. That one's going well. King Philotheos, the usurper, is a renowned fighter and tactician after having introduced himself to Trond. Philotheos poisoned me with the offer. He's willing to spend some time teaching Trond how to fight in exchange for your favor. Yeah, that would be useful. A point of marshal is nothing to scoff at. Yet, when I feel tired when I want to bed, I should do something about my listless mind. Perhaps I need to spend some time alone. I'll get it over with. If the world is dangerous place and devious plots are everywhere, rumors have reached that people are conspiring to kill you. Did I change my focus? Yeah, not yet. I was gonna change it to family. Get a little bit to canceling out my fertility penalties from chaste. which is 15, and so through minus 30, plus 25, plus 20, so 45, 45, minus 30, so I'm at like plus 15, so Dean, I think, so that's actually not too bad, and I really want this one to this one to poop out some kids. Oh, she does not have a bed. Yeah, her treasury's pretty decent. Maybe we'll be able to get that with us too. Okay, let's actually fight this war and let's see how well that goes for us. We've been fighting a few wars for Hungary right now. Duchess of Kiel. Doing my best to Kingdom of Ruthenia. Let me see, we've got 12. We need 3 more counties. So one holy war against these guys, and it should fully build with 1700. I'm not quite feeling it. But this would actually mean that. Actually, Chernigov is going to join our empire, I think, anyway, and defending against. Anyway, I'll fulfill my duties as expected. These guys are getting attacked, defending against High Chief and Vladimirian. Well, that's actually pretty good. If you succeed there, we'll get a county, and we'll be able to do something about that. God's blessing to bring the true faith, salvation to others is among the holiest of duties. Could there be asked to construct a new church? Sure, we have some places where building a church is relatively cheap. Like here. Making more and more churches in Finland should probably help. I think it does something to convert it, because it feels like places with churches held by bishops convert faster. It could just be what I think it is rather than what it is, but, you know. Count Espen of Yeland, the Count of Yeland, used to, people that I do not give a shit about are trying to kill each other, whatever. Let me see, I have never been monastery for a few days surrounded by others who have shared my passion for God. Could possibly, it's this one. Which one do we need the most? Probably the stewardship, actually, just to keep the money rolling in. Discussing the intricacies of managing a realm. Yep, 2 stewardship. That's actually pretty good. Gotta say, this emperor turned out pretty good. 50 years old, still running. Hope you'll be able to actually convert Finland. Ah, okay, we're not going to be friends. That's not too bad. Honestly, the stewardship bonus is going to be pretty important. Who is imprisoning him? My High Chief Vitebsk. Strong Queen of the Chieftain of Zemgal. Oh, yeah! Yeah, I lost that one during the thing. I once actually had that one, so that's interesting. That one's got a lot of things where he's defending against a host. That's fine. Hopefully Lithuania will weaken somehow. Ooh, Russian Holy War for Bjarmia. Russians pulling it in. Yeah. Good work, Russians. Because if you get to take all of that territory, that's really, really good. Okay, I'll give you. Now Sweden is being a little bit scary looking as a vassal, because it's got the... But The thing is, she is my daughter and of my dynasty, which makes this not quite as bad, and the fact that I'm still her heir, which is, you know, not too bad. And she's not gonna, probably not gonna even gonna have any kids, and then she's probably gonna die, and I'm gonna just absorb it into the empire. Is easily satisfied and obviously lacking ambition. He should be more charitable. He became content, which is not great, I gotta say. Diligent, patient is learning one, that's basically plus everything except martial. Diligent is just plus one of everything. I'm gonna get distressed, I'm gonna be thorough, make others count on you. Because diligent is, ambitious is technically a little better trait, but this is actually just plus one for everything, and it tends to stick for longer, and there tends to be other ways to get ambitious, so I like that. Yeah, I guess after we crashed, like, I swear I didn't do that deliberately, France is not attacking us. But Scotland is, yeah, is suffering a minor little revolt here. Attacking the Scottish Civil War, yeah, this is the Scottish Civil War. Or is it? Yeah, Scottish revolts. Yeah, all of this is the Scottish. I probably have enough money to actually build a church, which is probably fine. Let me see. Yeah, let's build a temple here. Yeah, this pleases me. This is actually quite fine. He's unlanded. But, you know, I will probably grab land for him sometime. I actually make sure. Okay, we don't have actually another commander. Make sure we can just hire one more person. Yeah, Alexandra seems like a good pick. So does Ulf. But Alexandra's actually, I'm gonna make sure to have all of these red. It's just annoying to have commanders that are, oh, he used a favor to get that one. But, yeah. Now we've got some truly exceptional commanders leading a superior force. We probably will lose. However, God has got to like us a lot because we've honored an alliance twice, so despite the rampant sinner and vicious rumors, he does really like us. Like, we fought two host wars off for him. Yeah, betrothal, which one is this one? It's two. Yeah, it's the one that guarantees the Russian non-aggression pact. I'm actually a big fan of that. Is still defending in this war. Yeah, he's agreeing with that. Let's give him a throwing axe. Let's also make him seneschal of the realm. Because I'm really trying to make him the make him like me enough to actually become Catholic. And if we can have a long running some technology points, anything we can improve that matters. 10 infrastructures, university 2 is not bad. The extra tax. Actually, I think I'm going to take town infrastructure just to get the instant tax boost. That's actually the thing. Oof, that is really nicely done by the vassals. Getting these territories into the empire, just, you know, besides us. Now Scandinavia is borders are for the exception of Lithuania, so neat around here. They just have all over the Finland and just have the rest over there. That is actually really nice. Yeah, I'm not gonna bother dealing with the rest of this host. Hungary can take care of itself, probably. I'll maybe call the stream onto a close relatively soon. Absolutely not. You are just not becoming. You are not getting to be a monk. What is wrong with you? You're about to inherit a really good empire. Well, okay, I guess the stress of that, you know, it could be really stressing to be an empire of an not to be ruler of an empire that goes between Scotland and Russia. I mean, that is, I guess, an empire that is stressful to uphold. I suppose. But no. Just no. Yeah, he's about to come of age. Hopefully he gets a good education out of the deal. Petition. Yeah, we already commissioned the church, so... Yeah, this is a new one. Why, Finland, why won't you just convert? You're the one county in such a long distance in all directions, and you still... Still won't just convert. Really hoping to be able to become leader of the order. Some people are trying to kill each other, that's fine by me. Disband that army and try hopefully to... Okay, the queen's only minorly pissed over that one. False religion, not much sure. Yeah, it actually won't work. If we'll have a kid, we can raise him and then have him inherit. Probably give him a title somewhere, then he'll inherit this, and we'll get a few counties for basically nothing. Count Uterigal. He's yeah, that's the conversus. Yeah, we are currently building a church here in Tevastehus. There's even a decent church here in Finland. Well, it's a church. Let me see, are we in a law change? We can just crown law, we can make current free investiture papal. Only the Pope, sorry, vassals with the bishop's opinion, church vassal liege opinion, head of religion opinion, minister. Okay, that means the Pope likes us a bit less, but yeah, the Pope isn't just like, he's got a lot of virtue on him. Yeah, it's not too bad. Yeah, he also might owe money to some Jews, but that's fine. Who cares if you owe some money to Jews? I can donate to charity. Gives spiritual guidance. I can't go through to myself, obviously. Can't do it to her. Maybe to... Let me see. Claim a Norke. What is going on? Attacking Sweden for Princess Ragnhild's claim on Norway. Yeah. No. You're not fighting my daughter over that one. God Gifu? What sort of name is God Gifu? Wulfvaru. Mildred. I like Mildred. Mildred is a nice name. I worked again, but the fair was costly, so if you could do me a favor. Sure. Very well, this war must end. Yeah, okay. With that revolt over, my daughter should be relatively secure, or probably likes me a bit more for having state diplomacy to vassal transfer. Very grateful. Long reign. Yeah, because I've actually been emperor. This character's been emperor for a fairly long time. 1187. Yeah, he's been 1189, 1124. He's been emperor for almost 25 years. Hungarians, get your shit together. You've got 7,000 troops. Why are they all over, like, there somewhere? I defeated them once back. That should have been enough. Ugh, he's so paranoid about the goddamn plagues. We don't have any plagues. Why do you keep doing that? The council has... mixed. Let me see. Go into hiding. I sure didn't want to go into hiding. Is anyone trying to kill me that I'm aware of? No, I don't. Just, I don't want to go into hiding. That actually seems quite fine. And Deshtpona, yeah, that's actually also there. And then finally, Copier. That one, unfortunately, is religion Sunni. Which is pretty hard to get me over there. How much is the send gift worth? 42. I'm gonna teach him a virtue. Have to be at peace for that to happen, so this stupid thing has to deal with. Maybe, that's like 527. Wait, what? Okay, this is probably the Hermetic Order thing or something. Revolt going on. No. Holstein, Eland, Shiland. We've already got troops. Just gather up in Poland. It'll all work out if we just gather up in Poland. Ugh. Seriously. With a mortal authority that's been at 100 for ages and ages and ages and ages. Oh yeah, Romney is technically independent. Versus... okay, that was actually over religion. Yeah, that's like... versus something with a moral authority of, like, 3. And, like, for how long have we actually had Finland? I'm pretty sure we've had it for ages and ages trying to convert it. Let me see. County of Finland, history... yeah, we... 11-8-99, so we've had it... 1200, we had it about 15 years. Your vassal count, you own a Burkinser, is concerned about his non-inheriting son. Have you considered him looking for new vassals? I can't for anyone who asks. I'm sorry. Seems like a decent enough chap, but it's just that we don't actually have a lot of land to dole out at the moment. So I think we're just going to try to... yeah, we're going to try to stuff something in the capital. We can make staples. I think I'm actually going to gather for the 409 to get the actual keep bonus. Because that actually is going to provide us with a hefty load of troops. not be that of that great. Okay, and now we can gather up there, get rid of those guys, and then get some peace. Then maybe we can get the Russians to like us just enough to be able to ask him to be... is that the second level? That's the first level. Your education sucks. You should use the power for good. Okay, at least you gain just, but with depressed, it's not that great in the meantime. Prince Wolf, okay, you got the, what, that's the level 2 one, right? Yeah, level 2 one. 1715. Yeah, he's just looking as kind of an all-rounder. Oh, okay, to be fair, having an all-rounder is just not that bad. We can probably get some ways to improve it. If we could just convert these things. Or actually, we might be able to try to stack up, instead of going for a keep, of just building more castles. That is also seeming like a legit plan right about now. Yeah, I think I'm probably gonna call it pretty much soon. It's getting a little late. And, you know, getting a little bit chance to just do things around there and going around and such. This empire has gotten to be really impressive. Over the course of approximately 150 years, we go over to just having Iceland to having all of this. So, gotta say, it's not bad. Actually, let's use this opportunity to actually, let's actually resign this time. Let's actually give us a little time to just look at where we our score and stuff. We're at, okay, we're not at like the highest, which is Capay, which is like 100,000, I believe. 100,000. We're only at 16,500, which is above House Wealth. Dynasty were down in one of its luck in 1066 by 1100. That had all changed. Control of two of the most powerful duchies in Germany and substantial lands in Italy made them the second most powerful family in Germany after the Hohenstaufen. One member of the Wealth family would even gain the title of emperor, but in the struggle, it would also weaken the family and much of the lands would be lost. The family would be consolidated, its holding in northern Germany as Dukes of Brunswick and remain a player in imperial politics. Okay. And let's just go over. Our first ruler, because he started out as 60 years old. We only ended up having him for 6 years, and we somehow had -32 score. Oh god. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. King Tater the Cruel. In our second character, we managed to actually be a king for a little while. Then we had to do one character as a duke when we lost an election. Then we got back to being king with King Harald the Usurper. Then Queen Profs the Wise. And this is one I find funny. Emperor Trond the Careless, who founded the empire, did all of these great things, but very early on was called the Careless, and even after 27 years of good solid rule was still called the Careless. Oof, 46. I'm pretty sure I wasn't emperor for 46, but I have ruled at least some parts of my lands for 46 years, because he was a lord when he was like a little baby, and then now he has been... but he's been emperor for a fair amount of time. He's been emperor for about half his life still. Because I believe he was 27 or so when he became emperor. And, you know, now he's 52. So yeah, he's been about 26 or so years. He's been a pretty good emperor, and I think this playthrough has been going pretty well. So, see you next week.